On the long list of jobs people do in this often bewildering 21st century, there might be one more unique than Henry Green's, but I haven't heard of it. Green is a master totem pole carver in northern British Columbia. He and his apprentice Gerald Stewart are members of the Tsimshian Nation. How does one become a Tsimshian master totem pole carver anyway?
By doing it. By applying yourself. You have to, it's something that you really have to want to do. There's nobody around to train me or nobody to show me what to do, so I pretty much just learned out of books.
Totem poles are vertical narratives in wood, layered with sacred power and symbolic meaning. At once the record of noble lineages, a legal claim to territory, and homage to the supernatural.
First figure on a totem pole has to be, first of all, it has to be well done, well finished, and it's usually the master that works on it, because it, when you walk up to it, that's the first figure that you see.
Totem poles as an art form flourished in the 19th century, but when Christian missionaries arrived from England, they decided that totem poles were the devil's work. Thousands were burned, others sold to collectors abroad, and some preserved in museums, like this one at the University of British Columbia. Slowly, like a figure emerging from solid cedar, native culture is reviving.
You might be wondering, what's the market for totem poles these days anyway? Well, according to Henry Green, it's not bad. A pole like this one will sell for about $125,000.
But money is only part of it, says Gerald Stewart.
Well, the biggest thing I see about it is not to give up, to fight for something you believe in, and just to continue to go on. And will it happen? I hope so. Do I want to give up? No, not in your life. Who will I be if I'm not Tsimshian?
So, as we all go on with whatever our jobs might be, factory worker, paper pusher, circus clown, journalist, thief, it's somehow comforting to know that Henry Green and Gerald Stewart are, bit by bit, turning a big piece of wood into a thing of beauty, an expression of the infinite variety of human creativity and spirit. Rob Reynolds, Al Jazeera, Prince Rupert, British Columbia.